No, Malay is my link. Today I represented animation for our final project for it. The first one I want to introduce the action for animations, that is stage performer and character animator share the common goal of presenting the audience with a believable character that is capable of supporting an impressive bond with audience. The second one is talent animation. What is animation? Animation is derived from the Latin term animal, which means to give life. This is the content I want to describe in our final project. After the best day of Kingdom Warriors, acting during audience Jenna in the amazing, and these people, their friends Snow Treasure and Steven, and the Raiding Deer take care of everything hand sound. Recently, shortly after Anna's invitation, I saw Guard Crixen and Anna and Cripples know her hiding place about hiding place forest surrounding the fork. There are always mysterious natural force which makes the kingdom and audience come even more children in my in mystery. Is magic and the death of the two friends' presence. This is briefly content. Now I represent the main content in the forest. The beginning of the story tracks back to the Snow Queen Elsa and her sister Anna when they born children. Listen to a story about the enhanced forest told her father and the Lucy Rain about the magical river from the mother. At the beginning, this and Anna's grandfather established a familiar relations with the tribe of the magical forest on behalf of the Oven country. Admitting winter adorn together as a witness to the peaceful coincidence to the two parties. The two parties who complete the ceremony fight voluntarily, and the leaders of the enhanced province become incapable. In the joys, Elsa and Anna's father, who were still young at the time, were enjoyed and fight. They were rescued and returned to the Andrea inherited the jewel. The forest has since become surrounded in mist. No one can enter and leave. As for the fantastic river, it said that the answer to the threats of the past, but you cannot indulge in it. Otherwise, it will be dangerous. With the same time, listening to the story night after first foreign movie, while Elsa was walking and living in the Emperor, he often hit the noisy ring, breaking himself. But for the sake of the Emperor and the relative, his friend Elsa had been suppressed in his instincts. Anna also finds the what was wrong with Elsa when to ask a comfortable cupped and to charge and zone and gradually fall asleep in the middle of the night as a water. Fire and earth. Andrew was enriched by the four forces, and everyone escaped from Andrew under the guidance of the stone spirit Elsa and Anna. Together with Anna's boyfriend, Jumping Eckless Deer, and Snow Treasures it of the ancient forest, finding the truth and solve the crisis in Andrew. Because of Elsa's eyes and stone magic, they subdued the wind, earth, and fire levels successfully. Because of Elsa's queen stages, it's discovered that Elsa and Anna's mother as members of the magical forest tribe, they temporarily solve the problems they lived in the magical forest. Emily's soldiers crash with the local troops. After these things came to an end when everyone took a break in the morning. In the evening, Ella learned that there was fifth and main spirit. Later, because of Ella's eyes, no magic stone giant appeared. Everyone did panic in order to quickly find out the truth. Elsa decided to immediately go to the fantastic river to find the fifth animal spirit, and Anna insisted on going together. So Anna and Elsa Shuibao were temporarily separated from the charm and stuff. On the way to the final magical river, Anna and three saw vacant of his prison ship died a few days ago. They learned from that the reason why Frederick went to sea and was to find the mystery of the last life, its brilliant eyes, and snow magic. Being more determined to find the magical river to solve all the puzzles for Anna's safety, Anna descended to Anna and she walked back to the intact forest while she headed towards to the sea. Anna and Shuibao incidentally break into the storage and territory in order not to wake sleeping the So joined the two zoned and board into a cave. At the same time, a large fight with the water levels in the sea. After trying the water level, Elsa reached to the Fantastic River with the help of Walter Slivy, find that it was a giant river corresponding with ice and snow. The voice is guided Elsa before calling was from here. Elsa is Elsa for a fit as it is easy and easy when she came home. And she confirmed that she was the fifth element. If he heard from the mother's voice and saw some of the past between the grandfather and the magic forest, but Elsa insisted on finding a deeper truth, so she fell into a ice volunteer and got to choose, but she was forced because of it. At last a moment, Elsa sent to Anna to the last message, pointing out that the grandfather, since the leader of the magic forest trip needed to the events of the year, gradually disappeared. She about guessed that something happened to the illustrious bird disappeared. Elsa have the accident, travelers probably did not know where they were. Anna was broke and sad, but in the end she cheered up and decided to destroy the den created by the crazy and unlock the magic forest mist. Anna ran out of the cave and woke up the snow giant, hoping to destroy the den by attracting the snow giant attack. When they were about to overtaken by the snow giant, Christine and Stoll's appeal ran to the den. And Anna, after some twins and twins, Anna finally tracked some snow giant to destroy the den. The den was joined, the fog of the enhanced forest gradually disappeared, and water flowed down in the intense rushing towards Andren. At the same time, Anna was broke and fell to the bottom of the sea along with the ice face. He was secured the water, rushing Andren without delay, changed the flow of the water with ice and snow magic, and rescued the Andrew at a critical moment. After that, Anna, Elsa, Crystal, and Scepter joined together to rescue Snow. With magic, the five gathered the crystal, proposed Anna, and Anna happily agreed because of her identity as the fifth element of the enhanced province. Elsa passed the identity of Queen of to Anna and released the forest here. In the end, Elsa grants the enhanced forest. Anna promised the Andrew and the close relation between the two sisters and make the relation between the two people truly join hands and coexist peacefully. I mentioned the practical aesthetic provide a unique tool to break down a strict lens screen. This simply three-step process here for actor to choose the best actor for the character actor. First one is what is the character actually doing? Second one is the essential action. What character is doing the screen? What is action like to me? As if. Excellent addition to the animation, movement based in it with constant fine by fine with character motions to maintain the intent of the director. For example, I screen the two pitch girls. The picture shows us that Elsa is pulling out of air fire. Her expression is serious, let the Kira take the sister away. She stays to put out the air fire, show his selfless and selfless character. And finally, she found the vice. He not only did not hurt her, but also went to complain with her. It is playful. So that Elsa is not afraid. The air is lying in hand happily and comfortably. It can be seen that Elsa is a very kind person. The plot of the piece is very successful. In this picture, I give the two pictures. In this picture, Elsa's preparation character is great in order to save others. He's desperate and he's not afraid of difficulties. He rushed to the water and over again. She came along and she don't bring sister. He knows his battle is the life and death struggle. Later, she jumped the water and the water if took to the Fantastic River. Later, she finally find the truth about the mother. She created a prison for wage intercy and a demitable spirit character. Conclusion: a practical aesthetic, especially in the three-step screen analyze tool, has proven itself simple yet effective to sit easily adapt into a remote process. A practical aesthetic, while relative new, departs from this conventional theory and is well suitable for implementing into animation production. Having established the understanding of a label contacting technology for animators from the experts, this technology provides the means for effective creating performance through applying a simple analysis tool into a pre-production state of the animation. This is all my present. Thank you, Doctor.
see from the soundtrack. And also, I not know much about what is enumeration. I know my enumeration has three steps, theory and analyze tool. And also, I know what is scenography, what is space, what is confusion and color, what is adaption. Adaption is that I can change the plot to my self liking. And I know what is audience, including human and non-human. And I also know what is fandom, what is science fiction. And I know what is palatial theater, including different things. And I also know what is submitting of things. And I also know not all about how to write fictions. That is my all I have already learned about it. Thank you, doctor, for teaching us.
My part in our assignment is literature enumeration. The length of our assignment is 4 reasons. This is a Disney movie which was trained by the interesting. My partner and I divided the task. I was responsible for explaining and analyzing the enumeration and the enumeration in the foreign. I watched the movie first, then found some classical clips and take screenshots and nice enumeration content through pictures and characters.
Frozen adaptions. The film Frozen, when their kingdom becomes trapped in perpetual winter, fearless Anna joins forces with mountaineer Kristoff and his reindeer sidekick to find Anna's sister, Snow Queen Elsa, and break her icy spell. Although their epic journey leads them to encounters with mystical trolls, a comedy snowman, harsh conditions, and magic at every turn, Anna and Kristoff bravely push onward in a race to save their kingdom from winter's cold grip. The books, The Snow Queen by Hans Christian Andersen. The story started when a young boy's heart is pierced by a splinter of glass and turned to ice. His name is Kay. He is taken away by the Snow Queen. His closest friend, a young girl named Gerda, goes on a courageous journey to save him. Her kindness and loving nature convince everyone she meets to help her on her travels. And at last, she reaches the palace of the Snow Queen where she restores his heart and frees him from the Queen's icy grip. So that was a difference between the story from the books and the film. The Snow Queen was really of the two friends, best friends, but the Frozen took the sibling story, sisters Anna and Elsa. Our story then shifts to a little boy and girl named Kay and Gerda, who are the best friends and neighbors. When Kay gets a piece of the mirror in his eye and heart, his personality changes, and not for the better, but for the worse. He is later saved from freezing to death by the Snow Queen, who takes him north with her. Here, he forgets his family and Gerda. What difference between the Snow Queen and Frozen? The Snow Queen centers around the life of best friends Kai and Gerda, two young children who are the story's protagonists. Frozen updates the dynamics of the two main characters. The siblings like Kai and Gerda are transformed into sisters Anna and Elsa. The original fairy tale is the longest of Andersen's. It's written in several parts, plenty of content for the Frozen writers, as well as a live-action adaptation of the story. Kristen Burr, Christopher Robin and Cruella have been named as the producer. Many choose to use live-action films as it has proven successful for the Disney film empire. The best part was nobody knows the story, flow, nor the hints of Anna and Elsa in any place. The Snow Queen has been adapted into numerous films, plays, operas and ballets. Disney's journey with the story began in the 1940s when many of Andersen's fairy tales were being explored for animation. The project was ultimately shelved through exploration continued in the 1970s for a Disneyland attraction called the Enchanted Snow Palace, which did not come to fruition. The Snow Queen began its transformation into Frozen in the early 2000s. This story adapted in about 70 years. So it took very long time. While the final film departs from the original story, the theme of regeneration through fate is lead characters' abilities and a journey through mountains for reunification remain. Frozen, why it took Disney so long to adapt The Snow Queen? When Disney released Frozen in 2013, the tale of royal sisters Elsa and Anna proved to be one of the studio's biggest hits, winning 2 Oscars, grossing over $1.2 billion at the box office, and bringing the increasingly obscure Hans Christian Andersen's base roaring back into pop culture relevance. But bringing the Snow Queen to the big screen was an ordeal that took Disney more than half a century to accomplish. Disney has adapted other Hans Christian Andersen stories with varying degrees of modernization, from the relative faithful adaptation of The Little Mermaid to The Emperor's New Clothes, which served as very distant inspiration for the drastically reworked The Emperor's New Groove. The Snow Queen lacked many key elements that would end up in Frozen, most importantly the central sister dynamic, and while the change to the Snow Queen do manage to make Frozen feel distinctly modern. The root problem that inspired those changes was apparent from the earliest stage of ideation, the villain is Snow Queen who will eventually become Queen Elsa. Disney began considering an adaptation of the Snow Queen in the 1930s, but felt unable to translate the motivations of the title character onto the screen. This problem was abandoned when the studio refocused on propaganda during World War II and would not be revisited until Walt Disney Animation Studios had re-established its industry dominance in the 1990s, following the Disney Renaissance. Many of the creative attached to or eye for the project then would eventually leave for the other ventures. Frozen, as it was released, began in earnest in 2008 when Chris Buck pitches an embryonic version of the idea. Still meant to be produced using traditional 2D animation, the film then called Anna and the Snow Queen languished in limbo until late 2011, when it would finally be given the name Frozen and the sibling relationship between Elsa and Anna would be established. Frozen, every failed Disney attempt to adapt the Snow Queen. Before Frozen arrived on the big screen in 2013, Disney had been trying and failing to adapt the Snow Queen since the 1930s. Disney's first planned adaptation of the Snow Queen did eventually get made to naught by Disney. In 1936, producer Samuel Goldwyn came up with the idea to make a movie about Hans Christian Andersen that would feature several of his stories. At around that time, artists at Disney were also visually developing animated adaptations of Andersen's story. The Snow Queen was among the stories that Disney's artists were developing, seeing a potential opportunity to combine their ideas by having a Hans Christian Andersen movie with animated segments. Goldwyn and Disney entered discussion for a picture where Samuel Goldwyn Productions would shoot the live-action portions, and Disney would animate the fairy tales. One of the creatives who worked on developing the Snow Queen at Disney was Glyn Keane, a character animator who worked on several Disney Renaissance movies and who went on to develop a visual for Tangled. In a 2011 interview with Den of Geek, Keane expressed his hope that Disney would figure out a way to bring the fairy tale to life, saying the Snow Queen is a wonderful story. Its root goes way, way deep, frighteningly deep. Disney continued to pursue the idea of a Snow Queen movie even after Keane's departure. James B. Stewart's book Disney War recounts a creative meeting of Disney Future Animation team where Snow Queen was discussed. At that time, the idea in play was for a Taming of the Shrew type story where the Snow Queen freezes the hearts of her many suitors before finally having her own heart melted by a regular guy. According to Stewart, then Disney CEO Michael Eisner loved the idea, but like the many other versions of the Snow Queen before it, it never came to fruition. Frozen was very different to the Snow Queen. Everything Disney changed. Anna and the Snow Queen. The roots of Frozen as we know it today can be found in Frozen co-director Chris Buck's original planned adaptation, Anna and the Snow Queen, which entered development in 2008. As the title suggests, it was this version that changed Gerda's name to Anna, but kept the idea of her going on a rescue mission to the Snow Queen's palace. The Snow Queen was still a villain, and Kristoff existed in the form of the boy that Anna goes to save. Megan Mullally was attached to play Elsa, and Josh Gad, who voices Olaf, also became attached at this stage. However, Anna and the Snow Queen was afflicted by the same story and character problems that had plagued just about every other version of adaptation. Chief among them, the challenge of the Snow Queen herself. In Andersen's story, she is deliberately mysterious, not particularly malevolent or evil, but simply distant and beautiful, working as a force of nature. She did not work particularly well as an outright villain, and so in early 2010, Anna and the Snow Queen went back into development hell while Disney focused its attention on Tangled. Sometime between then and December 2011, when Frozen was officially announced with its new title, someone at Disney, producer Peter Delveco, says that no one quite remembers who came up with the idea of Anna and Elsa being sisters. Everything finally fell into place and Disney finally succeeded in bringing the Snow Queen to life. More about adaptation. Frozen is a CGI film and one that certainly takes advantage of the technologies it can use. As I was digging into the animation of Frozen, apparently applying fractal mathematics to CGI backgrounds helps this look more realistic. This technology makes the setting of Frozen and other CGI films look more realistic and three-dimensional. The Snow Castle in particular is an amazingly animated building and one that took over 40 animators 9 months to finish. The film itself had a team of 600 and took 2.5 years to finish. Arendal, the setting for Frozen, is based on the Scandinavian country of Norway. The team had gone on a 2-week-long research trip to Norway before they began to make Frozen. The team took their ideas on the clothing, music, architecture, and landscape of the film. With the castle being inspired by Akershus fortress in Oslo, Arendal's town was inspired by Bryggen, a city on the west coast, and the surrounding area by the narrow forge. The art director of Frozen, Michael Giacomo, had previously worked as the art director for Pocahontas and also worked on Home on the Range. Giacomo's design for Frozen was inspired by Mary Blake's work in Cinderella and Peter Pan, as well as the work of Ivan Ure in Sleeping Beauty. Giacomo talks about three things that he and the team used in the art design of Frozen that day. They used to the triangle lines of roof and shingles of medieval Norwegian architecture and rosemary folk art. Rosemary is a decorative folk art. It involves decorative painting of ornamental flowers, scrollwork, linings, and geographic elements onto wood, typically in flowing patterns. This can be seen in the architecture, decor, and the costumes of Frozen. The costumes are some of the most elaborate in a Disney film, and the dresses have pleats, and the pleats act like pleats in actual dress. It was a really cool touch. And it was great. Like in other animated films, a live render was brought into the Disney studio so that the Disney animators could draw Sven in a realistic way. The animator of Olaf, Lino Di Salvo, did the initial animation of Olaf in the traditional hand-drawn style and then transferred it to his CGI character. This is the resource. Instead of completely tabling the story, they put it on hold until the studio could figure out how to adapt the story. Originally, Elsa was going to be the villain of Frozen, but when the production team heard the song Let It Go, they thought it was too positive and had too many positive values to be a villain song. This then caused the story to be changed, making Elsa more of an isolated character who is struggling with her powers and the fact that she could hurt the people she loves. Specifically, filmmakers have opted for giving prominence to female characters, and Elsa and Anna are the latest examples of the strength and empowerment that Disney princesses are currently acquiring. That's all from me about the adaptation of The Frozen.